top of the world with Times Network. And you're watching ET Now.
Hi there, everyone. Good afternoon. This is Riding the Bull, and I think the bulls are being challenged and how.
Yeah, they are. They're taking it easy today. The selling pressure has mounted. The Nifty has drifted below the 8750 mark. Overwhelming number of declines in trade today. It's clearly autos and realty, Avan, which are really the biggest drag. But Mandar joins in to talk about his technical thoughts on trade. Mandar, would you say this is a decisive turnaround by the market? And is it now sort of sniffing of a continued correction, considering up until now we were just holding around that 8800 sort of mark? And today is a sizable fall by the broader markets as well as the frontline indices.
Yeah, good afternoon, Ayesha. See, rightly said, I think if we compare the trading that has happened today to whatever happened in the last 8-9 trading sessions, then yes, it seems like a decisive fall. But at current levels, the Nifty is trading above a crucial support. 8715 and 8690 is a good support band for the Nifty, which from which the Nifty has managed to bounce back or has managed to hold on for the last 9 trading sessions. So I would be watching this band closely. And in the last 8-9 trading sessions, we have also witnessed buying coming in at these lower levels. So at current juncture, I think we need to wait and see whether the Nifty manages to bounce back. On the intraday charts, 8740 is a resistance for the Nifty. If 8740 is broken on the higher side, then yes, quite possibly we could see a pullback to 8770. And on the downside, 8715, 8690 is a support. If that's broken, then yes, going forward, we could see some kind of a correction in the markets, in which case the Nifty could even slide down to 8550.
And your top picks?
Yeah, Avan, first stock is Oil India. This stock has been showing good undercurrent in the last few days. Today in the intraday trade as well, it's showing good kind of buying coming in. 338 is a good support at current levels as it trades at around 340-350. As it trades above 338, I think the potential of moving higher is there, and therefore a positional buy with a stop loss at 335 for a target of 370. The second stock which has been showing strength lately is GAIL. This stock also on the charts has formed an aflac formation on yesterday's closing. Therefore, a short-term investment buy with a stop loss at 487 for a target of 538. And the third stock is a trading bet. Oro Pharma has been trading with weakness lately, and at current levels, it's broken a support at around 656. The next support comes in at around 621. So expecting that support to be tested, I think one can go short with a stop loss at 647 for a trading view, target 625.
But we've got some viewer queries lined up as well. And first up, a live caller joining in on the show with a question on Tech Mahindra. We have Pramod Deshpande with us on the phone line from Pune. Thanks for connecting with us. What's your query?
Ma'am, I have 250 shares of Tech Mahindra at an average price of 650 rupees. So shall I hold them and whether I can average them?
Okay, let's get straight to it. The stock price currently trading around the 500 mark. What do you think he should do right now, Mandar? He's losing quite a bit of money. What should be his ideal position in a space that's been clouded with so much fear and concern?
See, Evan, basically the stock in the last 3 months has moved from levels of 410 to the current levels of 500. And at current levels, there is a resistance, a tough resistance for the stock. So therefore, I think he can continue to hold the, I don't see a major upside from here. If the resistance is broken, then yes, there could be renewed interest which comes in. So therefore, he can do two things. One is, if the stock witnesses a correction from current levels, then maybe there's a support at around 420, 440. So you can think of adding at those support levels. Or once the resistance is broken, which they would then suggest that yes, the upside or the upward move starts, at that moment he can think of adding. So beyond 520, if you have a breakout beyond that resistance, then he can think of adding, or maybe add at supports around 420. But at current levels, he should continue to hold. The stock right now is in a sideways trend.
Okay, got another query, in fact, and Rakesh Kumar, he's bought about 500 shares of NBCC. In fact, he joins us on the phone line right now. Hi, Mr. Kumar, what is your question on NBCC?
Yeah, I'm holding this. I got it from IPO issue, NBCC. Mm-hmm. So 500 shares at the rate of 235.
Okay.
So should I hold or sell it? I mean, that's a query.
Okay.
Or see, I can...
Fair point. Let's just bring up that stock price and show you how it's currently panned out. 235 was his acquisition cost. 285 is where the stock is. This is, of course, the erstwhile favorite of the about 2 years back. A phenomenal ride is what the stock had already seen. Off later, it's gotten into a bit of a limbo, so to speak. But nonetheless, he is sitting on a profit. 285 is where the stock is right now, as opposed to his acquisition cost of 235. But Mandar, what would you recommend to him? What should he do? Should he take profits off the table or should he stick by with NBCC?
Aisha, I think he should continue to hold. He's bought it at a good price. See, basically last year, July, the stock gave us a breakout after a consolidation of 2 years on the long-term charts. So that was a positive. Then after that, it also corrected downwards to test the breakout level, and now again it is moving up. So this is a very nice formation on the long-term charts. I think looking at the monthly charts, it so suggests that the stock has got a 20-30% upside if the view is long-term. So with a 1-2 year view, one can expect a 20-30% upside from current levels. Therefore, I think he should continue to hold. The stock will be a good bet in the current markets.
Okay, that's a view coming in on NBCC. Mandar, thanks for guiding us through those viewer queries and your topics. We take a quick break right here on the show with news that we are currently perched at 87.40. Come right back for some more.